Hey everyone, it's me. I did this video once before, but I decided to reshoot it because the first time I did it, it was kind of messy and unorganized. So today I'm going to be talking about nail products, things that I use, and some colors of nail polish that I like. I'm going to go through things in the order that I do them when I do my nails. So I'll start with taking off the old nail polish. I just used this. It's from CVS. It's Nourishing Polish Remover. It just has vitamin E in it. Okay, after that, the next thing that I do is I take care of my cuticles. For cuticles, the moisturizer that I use is this Burt's Bees Lemon Butter Cuticle Cream, and it looks like this. It kind of looks like a lip balm. It's really thick and creamy, and it's really hard. Like, Burt's Bees, all their products are very natural, so there's a lot of organic ingredients in this. It smells just like lemons. It's very moisturizing, and what I do is I rub my finger in the pot a couple of times and get some product on my finger, and then I rub it across the base of my cuticles and then up each side, and sometimes I just do over the top just to give that part of the nail, or of the skin around the nail, some moisture. I do that to all my nails, and then I let them sit for a few minutes, and then I take this little gizmo, and this end is a cuticle pusher, and this end is like to scrape the extra stuff from underneath your nails, like any dirt or dead skin that gets under there. So I push all my cuticles back, and then depending on if I actually need to do this, I'll use this little thing next. And this thing right here is a cuticle trimmer, and I only just found out what these things are. I borrowed this one from my friend. She just said I could have it because she didn't know what it was, and I just wanted to see if I was right. But it's like this little Y-shaped gizmo, and it has a blade. Like, the part in the middle, it's a little blade. So what you do, it's kind of like a razor for your cuticles. What you do is you lay it flat with the Y on the, like, over your cuticle, because you know sometimes when you push the skin back, it gets like a ridge of cuticle skin because there's so much skin there. You run it over the ridge, and it just kind of shaves off that ridge of skin. And it makes your nails look a lot nicer, because that ridge of skin can sometimes, if you paint over it, it can look kind of messy, and it can cause your nail polish to kind of flake off from the base. So that's really irritating. But this thing, it's not supposed to hurt when you do it, because you're just clipping. It's basically dead skin that you're shearing off. So you shouldn't feel anything. If it hurts, then stop, because that means that you're nicking your actual, like, your skin, like down here. It's like you're cutting your actual skin, and that's not good. So this does not need to be used every time you do your nails. I use it maybe like every other week, kind of. I just do it if I feel that my nails, or that my cuticles need it. And then I just take a cloth, like a towel, or sometimes even use like the hem of my shirt, and I just rub the excess off of my nails, because the moisturizer, it gets on my nails, and if I were to paint over that, it wouldn't really go so well because the nail polish wouldn't stick. So I make sure my nails are clean, and then as a base coat, I use OPI's Nail Envy, and this is a nail strengthener. I don't really know how it compares to other base coats as far as like staying power or ridge filling or anything like that, but I use this because it's a really easy way to use a nail strengthener and still be able to paint your nails. It works. I mean, like, I still use a top coat, and I haven't had any particular problems with flaking or anything. It's kind of opaque yellow-ish, kind of, in the bottle, but when you put it on, it looks just like a clear nail polish. I do two coats of this, and you can wear this just as, like, a clear nail polish if you want. It works really well. It takes probably 2 to 3 weeks to see any real results in your nails. I've been using it for, like, probably about a month now. And I have pictures that I'll post at the end of the video and also on my blog of my nails as, like, through the weeks. Because this stuff, it works very, very well. If you're in the market for a nail strengthener, definitely recommend this stuff because it works really, really well. after I use the Nail Envy, then I will use my regular whatever color polish that I want to use, and I'll talk about some colors that I really like at the end. After the nail polish, I use a top coat. The first top coat that I tried was Fast Forward by China Glaze. This is very similar to Sechevit, however you say it. A lot of people here on YouTube, they rave about it all day long. They say it's wonderful, it dries your nails really fast. And I've tried it, and it does. And it makes your nails very hard and shiny. And so it's a good top coat, but the reason I don't like it is that it's so similar to this. And this stuff, it behaves in basically the same way as Sechevit, but what happens with this stuff is you can go at the base of your nail, and after a couple of days you can just like peel your nail polish off, and it comes off in like this goopy clump, and you can just peel your entire nail of polish off. And so I don't like that about this. The one that I routinely use is the OPI Top Coat. By itself, this stuff kind of stinks because it takes like 2 hours to fully dry. Well, not like 2 hours to completely dry, but it takes a really long time. So you can't like do stuff, which most people don't really like to wait around for your nails to dry forever. So what I use to make this stuff work, and the reason I like this stuff is because it makes the color stay a really long time. Like when I go to take it off, the color just doesn't want to come off because this stuff really, really locks it in. What I use to make it dry faster is OPI Drip Dry. And these are just little drops that you put one or two of on your nail after you use your top coat, and it makes them dry faster. You can also use this on regular nail polish, but don't use it in between layers because they put like moisturizing oils in here to help moisturize your cuticles after you do it. And if you put this on between coats, then that oil will prevent your next layer of polish from sticking properly. And I have a blog post about the ingredients in it and what they're supposed to do. So I'll put a link to that in the sidebar as well. Just really fast, for filing and clipping, I just use a really big nail clipper. I like them better, they're faster for me to use, and then I use they call them like diamond nail files, and I like them because they last a really long time, and this little tip can also be used for scraping under your nails. So I use those. Okay, then for colors that I really like, the one that I'm wearing right now is Yoga to get this blue. It's Yoga and then TA to get this blue, so it's kind of a play on words. Most of OPI's names are like that. It's a really pretty dark blue. I really like it. It's a very pretty dark blue shimmery color. Another color that I really like is dark purple. I am a purple person in makeup and in nails. Dark purple, I find that it's not as harsh as black, and I find it very, very sophisticated. This was like my first like real nail polish that I ever like kept for a prolonged amount of time. And this is Dark Angel by MAC. And I don't use this one very much because the formula is very thin and streaky. This one is by OPI. It's called Linkin Park at Midnight. There is one called Linkin Park After Dark, which is the same color but without shimmer. This has a silver shimmer to it, and I actually really like that. I think it looks very nice on dark nail polishes. Dark purple nails, probably one of my favorite colors in the whole world. I don't know why, but I love it. And then another color that I really like, this is actually the first OPI color that I ever really fell in love with. And it's called Miami Beat, and it's kind of like a magenta purple color. And it's really, really pretty. And for neutral nail colors, my all-time favorite color has to be Sandy Beach by Essie. This, I don't think they make it anymore, which makes me really sad because, like, I'm down to about here on the polish, and I've never used that much of a nail polish before in my life. So I'm afraid to use it anymore because I don't want to run out of it. I'm sure there's a similar color, but I'd have to go and find it, and I really like this color. It's a very natural color. You can hardly tell that you're wearing nail polish. It just looks very clean and sophisticated. I'm using the word sophisticated a lot today. Another neutral color with shimmer is this one by OPI. It's called Sand in My Suit. And it's kind of like a beigey tan color with silver shimmer. And this is like, it's just a really nice natural color. with some shimmer if you want, like, if you're into more shimmery colors. So, that's pretty much all I've got. Those are my nail treatments and nail colors. And if you guys have any nail colors that you really, really love and you want to share, then put a comment down there. And I would really love to see them because I've really gotten into finding new colors of nail polish. So if there's any really pretty colors that you guys are in love with, let me know because I would like to check those out. And also if there's another nail product that you guys really like, leave me a comment about that too. But I hope you guys found this helpful and I will talk to you soon. Bye.